Welcome back. This is Carter for OpenSpace. I'm just going to show you now in our next tutorial a few more little tricks of the trade. With Earth, as we come up, we default into this image of Earth that's supplied by NASA GIBS. That's the Global Imagery Browse Service from NASA Goddard Space Flight Center. And they bring together these global mosaics of Earth from NASA's Earth Observatory, or NASA's Earth Observing System, and that you can see many different wavelengths and so forth. But we're looking at the nice red, green, blue image that's created every day. And it's built up over time. It's built up over a day. It's a full daily mosaic. And if I come closer, I'm using the right mouse, and letting me come in closer and closer. Let's come up here to North America, to the United States area. In fact, let's come into some mountainous area over here near the West Coast. We're gonna come in closer, and as I get closer, at a certain point, you'll notice that daily image, the clouds go away. And what we're going into is a more highly resolved Earth image that has a cloudless Earth, but it also has the bathymetry of the ocean. And this is from our friends at the ESRI company, the world's leading GIS company, and they make this map available. And so we're streaming this live when we do this over the web. So if you're online with this, this should be coming in for you, subject to the vagaries and the speed of the internet. So as I come in, let's come into Mono Lake, fairly obvious lake with an island in the middle of it, just east of the Sierras, actually quite close to Yosemite Valley. In fact, Yosemite Valley is sort of directly east of Mono Lake on the other side of the mountains of the Sierras, and I'm going to come closer, and I'm coming closer and closer, and coming in radially, and that's basically what the right mouse button allows you to do, get really close. But if you come down like this, you're just looking down. If we want to look over to the side, what we can do is use the left mouse button and depress the control key. So if I depress the control key, that allows me to now pan around where the camera is. I'm not moving the camera, I'm just changing the orientation of view. So in this case, let's say I want to look toward the horizon, like this. And then I let go of the control key, and with the right mouse button, I can still get lower and lower to finally I'm seeing the landscape come into view of the Sierra Mountains. And we'll see now this image will get better because we're closer, but now we're tipped over on our side. What I can do is use the control key again, depress the control key, and now I'm depressing the middle mouse, in this case the roller wheel on my mouse, and allows me to roll the image. And so this way we can straighten out the horizon. Now if I let go of the control key with the same middle mouse, it allows me to sort of look around the panorama. So I'm panning away from Mono Lake. Now I'm looking south. Now I'm looking more eastbound off into Yosemite Valley. And so here's Yosemite Valley. And now with the left mouse button, this allows me to sort of, I'm pulling the mouse toward me, and so I'm pulling the landscape toward me. I can stop. If I want to go lower, once again, grab the right mouse, and I can come lower. Yosemite is one of these places on the Earth that this data set has some very nice high resolution for. Think of this in a way kind of like what Google Earth does, that not everywhere has high resolution imagery. And if you get too close, you might see some white squares come up, and you just have to sort of back away to where those go away. So this is Half Dome right here. And also we can see the atmosphere, which is calculated by OpenSpace. And so that we're seeing a realistic atmosphere and this image of Earth. Now, to go back up, what I'm doing is, once again, grabbing the right mouse, and I'm pulling it down, which means that if I pull the mouse toward me, with the right mouse button depressed, That usually means I'm moving away from my object of interest. And as I do, looking back up into space, and I see these orbit trail lines, including that of the Earth. Now, also, we can see how thin the atmosphere is. It's only about 20 miles or 30 kilometers thick. And so it goes to black pretty quick. And this is why the astronauts remark about how incredibly thin the atmosphere seems to be. And you can get a feel for that in open space by looking at this interactively, coming and going down to the scales that we're used to seeing if we climb mountains and get up high, or even get down lower and to places on Earth and look up and you see the beautiful blue sky. But quickly, as you go up, it becomes space and we're looking back down. So with this, I'm going to sort of move my view looking back down, nadir view, and I'm moving out with the right mouse button again. And if I pull out far enough, that daily image fades back on as we move on out away from Earth. Thanks.